It's Raven, and just a quick video today, for the moment, anyway. This is gonna be a little different. It's just taking just a little principle that I've found works really, really well for detailing. So we're gonna go ahead and I'll show you kind of what I do to get to what I do for detailing, I guess, for lack of a better term. Sorry, I'm a little bit tired right now, but it is what it is. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna grab some crystal here. I'll explain this all in just a moment. And set symmetry, just to kind of give us... I do this as a little bit of an exercise from time to time to kind of get an idea of what the heck I'm doing. So we're gonna... Oh, that's not what I'm meant to do. I want right there. Hold on. So I do this a lot. It's kind of like doodling on a scrap of paper during, you know, math class or whatever. For me anyway, it's kind of how this feels, I guess, for lack of a better term. So first things first, we're gonna lay down our base of any color crystal you want, really. I like to use crystal because they emit light and it's easy to see how things work. So in detailing, everything comes down to layers. So our base layer here is gonna be the crystal. You could think of it like an engine intake or something like that. And so from what we're gonna do is essentially just make a little pattern, a little design. And I'll show you kinda how I go about doing detail work, for lack of, I guess, is the best way to say it. So from here, we know that this is our center point. I'm doing this on up, down, and left and right symmetry. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and kind of lay out a little something. I'll do another one here. I kind of have an idea of what I'm doing, but I really don't. I just kind of let stuff happen for the most part. That's not what I meant to do. Undo button is amazing. I don't know why I didn't use it initially, but whatever. So we're gonna go ahead and put on this. And so this is kind of our base level, just a very, very small, or a very, very simple sort of thing. Let's go out here. Yeah, why not? So, and so what I'm doing, like I said, is I'm just laying down a base. This is just gonna be the very, very bottom layer. And hopefully this will turn out okay by the end. But all we're doing is making a cool pattern. But, and this is kind of like, this is what I see a lot when I do ship reviews. I'll see like that much detailing. You throw something out, or this will be actually inlaid without the wedges into the, you know, the main hull, if the crystal were the main hull. But having, you know, coming out a block is really, really helpful. Now, this isn't necessarily enough. So we're gonna kinda, no, I don't like that. We're gonna just keep playing with this, get it to start looking nice. So we're gonna kinda go here. And then, in this case, we're gonna do some framing really quick. Actually, all of this is gonna go. Yeah. Sorry. Got a little bit of a cold still, unfortunately, so sorry if my voice doesn't sound quite up to par. It is what it is. You know, gotta love it. I'm always sick, it seems. So we're gonna go ahead and slap that down. For some reason... Nope, right. Yeah, okay. There we go. So this is the base frame that I'm working with. Just something I kind of whipped together. Not particularly special. We're gonna wedge it anyway because framing is important too. What you have around your detailing is just as important as the detailing itself. because if you don't provide, you know, a frame for said detailing, it just won't look very good. So we're here, and this is what I see on a lot of the ships that, you know, I see that are pretty decent, but we're gonna go a little bit further than that. So how does one, you know, go about doing that? Well, you want to add more layers, and you kind of want to follow the rule of prime numbers for your layers. So you want to go for threes or fives. I tend to just leave it at three because it keeps it simple enough. It keeps your detailing simple enough that it's easy on the eyes. You know, it looks good, but it's not overly done. So just get that. All right, and you'll notice I'm connecting this stuff too, which is also pretty important. Yeah. So right now we've got our base layer, which is the crystal, and then this layer, which is kind of the first detail layer. But then we've got what I'll call a negative layer, which is nothing. There's nothing that's gonna be right here. We're gonna go out one layer from there. Let's go ahead and get these connected up real quick. But you'll notice I connected up this layer to the base layer. And doing that tends to be really, really nice. It looks good. So I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of this and that, and yeah. Slap that down, and I don't think that's right. There we go. That's better. And a lot of this is just practice and finding your own style. And I have my own style. But, you know, playing around with this sort of thing tends to help. And just remember that, you know, wedges don't just work sideways. You know, you can do them all over the place in any direction you want. But yeah, so what we're basically doing here, I'm actually going to bring all of this in. Keep the lines thin, because the lines are thin everywhere else on this design. And I don't want, if you're going to do thicker lines, you want them closer. I don't 100% know why, but it tends to look better that way. Closer to the main area, that is. So we're going to go ahead and get rid of all of that. And we're going to go ahead and slap in this. There we go. So one of the cool things about detailing like this, anyway, is when you look at it straight on, it has a certain look, but as soon as you start turning and looking at it from other angles, what you're seeing changes. It's actually, that. Go ahead and slap that down as well, and we'll add a little bit more. So that comes in, it tends to look just a little bit nicer. Again, framing. Very important. Right here we've got a single, so we'll go like this. So I can use the same direction in this case. Now, this doesn't always work. If you have something that's taller, you tend to not want to use up-down symmetry at all. It just doesn't look nearly as good. So don't. Just a little bit of a tip from plenty of playtime, etc. But yeah, it's just, I see a lot of cool ships all the time. And I see a lot of cool ships that just need that little bit more. And maybe this will inspire you guys, there's, you know, somebody out there to give it that little bit more and show you how to do it, and that's kind of what I'm aiming for here. Yeah, we'll leave that open. So, you kind of got a basic engine intake that, you know, looks a little different. It's got three layers and then one negative layer, and the negative layer doesn't actually count as a layer. At least not in my opinion. So, it tends to cancel itself out there. Yeah, yeah, I'm liking this, And a lot of this is trial and error. A lot of this is just kind of screwing around. So I liked that, but we're gonna try something a little different. Just to see what it looks like. One of the general rules that I learned early on as well is never really be afraid to delete something. Because no matter how much you worked on it, if it can be improved, it can be improved. So just, you know, don't worry about it too much. Just kind of go with it. That means this whole part needs to come up and fill that area. Let's try... Okay. So then we go here. And here. And you get some cool little designs and stuff like that. All of this sort of just helps out, but basically just remember you want you want several different layers. And one of the cool one of the fun things to do is this layer right here, the first layer of black hull over the crystal, think of that as your hull. And then inset into your actual shell, your hull, and do detailing that way, and it tends to really, really help and look really, really cool. No, I don't like that. But yeah, it's just a little thing that I've been thinking about a bit, and I'd like to try to help you guys out a little bit, and I haven't really been able to put this in words all that well. And I'm not sure that this is really put into words all that well. I mean, considering the fact that I'm freaking like loopy at this point, I'm pretty tired. I'm probably going to bed here in just a few. But, you know, it's just one of those things. This is one of those things that I would suggest doing. Just screw around, you know, go get some crystal or something like that. Again, I do that just for the lighting effects. Do this and then. And then try it out with maybe different colors. So if I wanted to, maybe I could grab, or I could do this in gray hull instead. We'll just, you know, delete all this, slap down some gray hull. And so you just want to kind of practice, I guess, for lack of a better term. All it is just practice. It's just screwing around and seeing what kind of look you like. But just remember, you got to think of it in layers, and you want to connect them, but not connect them by too much, because too much stuff running into there will be overwhelming. Basically, it'll end up looking bad. And I guess I have a few different kinds of hull there. Yeah, whatever. You guys get the idea. So yeah, this is, like I said, this is something I do randomly. I do this before every lineup, just about. Not everyone, but I try to. And these designs just sort of, well, one, they chill me the heck out, which is nice. But they make you think in layers. And that's a really good thing. Because that's what you're building. When you build, you're building in layers in a lot of cases, especially with your detailing, and you want it to be in layers. And the different ways that you can make the layers stand out from each other are different colors, and with different designs. But the trick is always to make it so that when you look at something dead on, so look at this, pretty much dead on, yeah, you get the idea. From there, you know, you're seeing a certain picture, but when you move, that picture starts to change. That's the real trick, and that's what makes good detailing. So with that, I think I'm just gonna kind of leave it at that, and I'm gonna switch this to standard armor for consistency's sake, because bugs me so much, and I can't click. Apparently, I just cannot click for the life of me at the moment. And this isn't necessarily the best example, but it's an example nonetheless that gives you an idea of what, you know, what you can do. And you know, letting stuff show through, etc., etc. It's a nice little bit. So yeah, from here, you know, play around with these sorts of designs, and then once you start to think in layers, you know, 3 to 5 layers per ship. You know, a bigger ship, you might want 5 layers on something, maybe even 7, in really highly detailed areas. But on a small ship, you're not going to have that kind of room. So 2 to 3 is usually what I aim for, and it might help out. So give it a go, see if you like if it works for you. It should. It's a pretty simple concept. Yeah. Anyway, that's all for me for right now. There'll be more ship reviews tomorrow. I just haven't gotten around to rendering everything because it takes a long time to do sometimes. So yeah, and I've been working on the tutorial a lot lately, so it just is what it is, you know, time. And yeah, but that's it for me. Thanks for watching. Sorry about my ramblingness, etc. I hope this helps out. Yeah, thanks for watching. Take it easy. See you next time.